Supplement 3, Building Vector Maps in pDRAW32. pDRAW32 is a free DNA analysis software from the AcaClone Software company. It doesn't have all the features of Vector NTI, but it's pretty good for simple DNA map building and for primer design tasks. In this chapter, I'm going to use pDRAW32 to build maps of PSAT6 MCS and PSAT6 bar and to design primers for amplifying the bar gene in PCR. To get started, I go to PubMed Nucleotide and find sequences of PFGC5941, which I will use as a PCR template for bar gene, and of PSAT6 MCS, which is the vector I will clone into. Then I launch pDRAW32, go to File, New, Enter New Sequence, and insert here the sequence of PSAT6 MCS. For that, I go back to the web browser, scroll down, select the sequence, copy it, go back to pDRAW32 and paste it. Now I'm going to add features to this sequence. I go to Edit and click on DNA Name, Properties and Annotations, where I can add the map features. I get the features of PSAT6 MCS from the PubMed file. I switch again to the web browser window, scroll up, and select the feature table view. You can see a list of PSAT6 features with their coordinates. Let's transfer them to the map. For each feature, I put its name, start and end position, orientation and type. Then I click on Add. After all the features have been added, I could display them with a preview button. Then I switch to the DNA Information tab. Here I insert the name of the plasmid and indicate that this is a circular DNA. Now it looks like a pretty map of PSAT6 MCS. Let's save it. Notice that if you want to see the restriction size on the plasmid map, you have to close and open pDRAW32. Now I'm going to build a map of PSAT6 bar by pasting the sequence of the bar gene into the PSAT6 MCS. Let's first save this map as PSAT6 bar. In pDRAW32, we need to separately edit the plasmid name, because it's not automatically imported from the file name. Now, let's go back to the PubMed nucleotide and locate the sequence of the bar gene. When we scroll down and look at the annotations, we could see that the sequence of the bar gene is located on the reverse strand in the positions 373 to 924. To make the life a little simpler, I will use the PubMed option called Change the Region Shown. I will insert here the coordinates of the bar gene and click on Update View. Now, in my web browser, I have the sequence of the bar gene that I am going to copy. Before pasting this sequence in pDRAW32, I want to change its orientation by using a utility called Sequence Manipulation Tool. I paste here my sequence, select Reverse Complement option, and calculate the sequence. Here's the sequence of the bar gene, starting with ATG and ending with a stop codon. I'm going to copy it and hide this window for now. Editing a plasmid sequence in pDRAW32 is somewhat not trivial, but it can be done. First, I open a sequence U window and locate the sites of ZO1 and BAMH1. Here we have CTC-GAG, which is ZO1. And here we have GGA-TTC, which is BAMH1. Please notice that those two restriction sites are located on lines beginning with nucleotides 1301 and 1351. Now I open an edit sequence window. Locate ZO1 site on line 1301 and introduce a line break after it. Then I go to the line 1351, locate the BAMH1 site and introduce a line break before. Now I'm going to remove the piece of multiple cloning site between ZO1 and BAMH1 and paste here the bar sequence. Now on the map you can see a fragment that has been inserted between ZO1 and BAMH1 sites. I'm going to annotate this fragment as the bar gene. For that I will go to Edit, DNA Annotations. And add a new feature. That will start in the position 1345, which is right after the ZO1 site. And end in the position 1897, which is right before the BAMH1 site. Now let's design the PCR primers. With the plasmid map at hand, it is actually quite easy. I'm going to open the sequence view window, hide all the ORFs, scroll down to the ZO1 side, select 20 nucleotides right after it and copy them with Ctrl+C. Then I will open the sequence manipulation tool and paste the sequence with Ctrl+V. I add 6 random nucleotides at the 5' end. Select the restriction site. And hit calculate. This is the primer sequence that I will send to an oligosynthesis company. Similarly, for the reverse primer, I will select last 20 base pairs of bar, paste them into the sequence manipulation tool, add 5' overhang, and restriction site. check reverse complement button, and hit calculate. Here I have shown you how to build plasmid maps and design PCR primers using some basic features of pDRAW32. If you would like to get a little bit more sophisticated, I would suggest you to play with the in silico DNA cloning feature that allows you to combine several fragments together while preserving all the annotations.